Hello guys, welcome back to another video. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Olga and I'm really happy to have you here. So yeah, for today's video I'm going to have for you the best makeup in 2020. Some of these makeups are drugstore and some of them are high-end. I just gonna put everything in one video because I don't have a lot of, I'm more like a drugstore girl. I think I have a lot of drugstore makeup and I don't have too, I have some high-end makeup but not too much, so for that point to make just a video for a high-end makeup. So that's why I'm including everything in this today's video. Also, some of these products are not a product that got released this year, that it was released like in another year, but I've been using that product a lot this year. That's why I mentioned that product in this video. So I just want to point those things out. So yeah, so these products are, in my opinion, the best product that some makeup brands have released, and they're really good. They work for me. So yeah, so I want to share those products with you. So yeah, so if you're interested to know what products are those, just stay there and keep on watching. Okay, so I'm gonna start with brows. For those people that follow me for a long time, you'll know that I really like this combo right here. This is a new pencil because I use this pencil a lot. So, and I need to have this as a backup. So this is the e.l.f. Ultra Precise Brow Pencil. Now I like to use the color Neutral Brown. I think this color goes really good for my brows. I'm not wearing this brow right now on me. I have this makeup tutorial link over here if you're interested to see the makeup tutorial. So yeah, so this is the e.l.f. Ultra Precise Brow Pencil in the color Neutral Brown. And I also like to use this e.l.f. Wild Brow. And I use this one in the shade Brunette. So those two products together makes a really good combo. And I really like these products for my brow. They are really nice. The formula for this brow are really similar for the Anastasia Beverly Hills. Once I discovered this product, I haven't buy any high-end brow product because I really like Benefit and I really like Anastasia, but this one, you know, this one beats them. This is really similar to them, so I don't feel the need to spend money where I can buy this one for $5 and it does the same job, you know. So I really like these two products for my brows, and I think this is the best thing that e.l.f. have come out this year. So moving on with complexion, for my primer, I've really been liking this one from Holly Henriksen, and this is the Banana Bright Face Primer. This primer is really hydrated and also give you a little bit of glow. And I've also been liking this one from e.l.f. and this is the Poreless Pudding Primer. I really like to combine primers that are really hydrating and put a little bit of pore filler right here in the center. So I really like to use two primers sometimes when I do my makeup. So I've been liking these two products. One is high-end and one is more affordable, but I really like these two products. For foundation, I have a few foundations that I want to mention and that I discovered this year and I'm really obsessed with it. This one is the Belief Beauty. You find this brand at Dollar General. And this is the Skin Finish Foundation. And like it says here, it gives you like a really skin-like finish. It's really radiant. It doesn't feel heavy into your skin. It's really lightweight and it's medium to full coverage. And on this one, I use Neutral Tan. It's the one that I'm wearing right now, but it's a little bit too dark for my skin tone right now. Since we are in the winter times, I get a little bit more like pale. So, but yeah, so I really like this foundation. And also ColourPop released this foundation that I tried, and I have a review of this foundation. I will link it right here if you want to check it out. And this is the Hyaluronic Hydrating Foundation, and this is the Pretty Fresh. So these foundations are really nice. All these foundations are really great for people who have dry skin like I do. So I really like this. This one has really like a radiant a finish, really natural finish. You can build this foundation to be a full cover foundation. Personally, I don't do that because I don't like full cover foundation. I kind of like do like a medium cover and that's it. So I really like this foundation. And also I've been liking this foundation for Morphe, and this is the Morphe 2. And this foundation is the Hint Skin Tint. And yeah, so this foundation is really, it says sheer to medium full covers, but I think this is more like a medium cover. And I really like this foundation. It's really lightweight too. So everything that I mentioned is lightweight, radiant, skin-like finish. It's like your skin but better. So I really like those type of foundation that will leave your skin looking like that at the end. So these three foundations are really great and I've been loving it all this year. I've been rotating this one. I've been using other foundations, but those three foundations are my like top favorite, and I've been using those three foundations a lot this year. So for concealer, I have a few three concealers that I want to mention, and this is the e.l.f. concealer and this is the hydrating camo concealer. E.l.f. also have a regular, the one with a black cap, but I like this one better because I feel like this is more creamy. The other one is a little bit too dry for my skin, and it look a little bit too like cakey under my eyes. So this one has a lot more creamy, and it blends into my skin really nice. It has a satin finish, so I really like that about this concealer. And the color is perfect because it covers my dark circles and also brightens my under eye. And I also like this. I'll also be using this one from ColourPop, and this is the Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Creamy Concealer. And like it says, there is really creamy under my eyes too. So these two things that they came out, I think they came out this one and this one was already ready for sale like before, but since when they released this, I bought this one and I was like, okay, well, I just gonna try both things together because it's on the same line. So I tried it and I really like it. It's really nice under my eyes. It's creamy, everything that I need. And also I've been liking this one from CoverGirl, and this is the True Blend Undercover Concealer. And this one I have in the shade Golden Natural. For this one from the Pretty Fresh, I have in the shade, where is the shade? It's Light 50W. And from this one, e.l.f., I have in the shade Light Beige. So yeah, so I will be leaving everything down below in case I miss something to say the shade name or something. I will link down below, that way you know what shade I am, in case y'all have a similar skin tone than I do. Okay, so this is the CoverGirl. The same thing, I like this concealer. It does great things for my under eye. It has really good cover. It's really creamy. It feels really lightweight. I really like it. They're all these three concealers are really nice and really great into my skin. Moving on with setting powders, I have two setting powders that I've been using a lot in this year, and this is one of those is the Collab Makeup, and this is the Set the Stage So Focused Translucent Finishing Powder. And it has a little bit of tint, but when you put it into your eyes, under your eyes, it illuminates your under eyes, giving the highlight look. And I really like that about this powder. And I also been loving this one from Dermablend, and this is the Illuminating Banana Powder. The same thing, it illuminates your under eye. This powder I'm using in my under eye, it looks really smooth and I really like it. It also have a little bit of tint. I like powders that has a little bit of tint, because whenever it's a white translucent powder, like a white, sometimes those powders give you like a little like a white cast when you take pictures, but this powder doesn't do that. I really been liking these two powders. They're really great. Moving on with bronzers. So bronzers, I have few single bronzers, and I also have a face palette that I've been loving this year. So I had this one from e.l.f., and this is I think e.l.f. released this powder this year. So I had this powder from e.l.f. and this is the Forever Sunskin. And so like you can see, it's a really kind of like, it's a warm tone, it's a neutral color, and I really like it. And they also have more colors for people that has different skin tones. In this one, this is the lightest color, but for my skin tone, it works really nice. I really like it, it's the best. And also I've been liking this one from Milani, and this is the Silky Matte Bronzing Powder, and the shade that I've been using is the Suntan 03. And I really like this powder, the same thing, it's really nice, it blends beautiful into my skin. I'm out of breath. It blends beautiful into my skin, the color is really nice, and yeah, so I've really been liking these two bronzy powders together. And for face palettes, I think this palette from Essence also came out this year. It's a great palette. This is the Sun Club Matte Bronzing Powder. And mine is taped out because when I received it, it was kind of wet. So this thing, like, it was wet. So I just, and it was coming off from the mirror. So it has a mirror. It has 40 beautiful shades. I mean, this palette works for every skin tone. I think you can find a color for you. For me personally, I think this, I can use this three colors. This one is a little bit too dark, and this is way too dark for me. So this palette, it worked for me for all the seasons. When I'm tan, I can use this palette, and when I'm fair, I can use this palette anyways, you know, because you have your two colors that are a little dark, a little lighter than this too. So this palette is everything. I really like it. The formula is really soft, really blendable, it blends really seamlessly into your face. I really like it. And plus has a mirror, and this is just $10, so you can beat that. $10 for four shades, pretty huge pan. So loving that palette too. So yeah, so moving on with blush. So for blush, I have these two blushes right here, and this is from the brand Olmay. This is the Healthy Huge Blush. I discovered these blushes in this year, and I've been loving these two colors. This is the So Peachy. That it says peachy, but it's more kind of like a rosy tone. Has a little bit of peach. I'm not into peach colors, but I really like more like a rosy cheeks. So this is the color, and this is the So Peach one. And I also have the pink blush. This is the color right here, and I think I also have the other color. I think I have all three colors. So this formula is really nice. It's matte, but it gives you like a little bit of like a sheen. It looks, when you put this into your skin, your skin looks like healthy, like it's glowing. And I really like how the finish from these blushes, they're really nice. It's beautiful. You don't get a lot of pigment right away. You gotta build these colors, but that's okay for a blush, because I don't want a blush that is really pigmented that you go one time and poof, you look like a clown, like a payasa. No. So I really like blushes that are like buildable. And yeah, so I really been loving these two blushes. And also the e.l.f. came out with the same from the bronzer, and I like this color specific, and it's always cheeky, and I really like this color. It's really nice. I really like it. I think I'm gonna be grabbing more colors because this formula is really good too. So yeah, so from palettes, I've been loving these little palettes that BH Cosmetics came out. I really like this palette, and I have three palettes. I have Chocolate Cherry Truffle. It looks like this. I have Vanilla Peach. It looks like this. And I have Vanilla Cream Truffle. And this is more kind of like I like this palette more than everything else, but I use those palettes too. And these palettes are really great. You get four colors. you can choose from. You can mix and match, you can create your own shade, or you can use, like I do, I use all the shades together, and I really like it. These colors are really great for my skin tone. And also the blushes that I've been using too a lot, and this one's from Alamar Cosmetics. I just want to mention these ones because I've been using a lot, but I don't think Alamar Cosmetics are selling these blushes. These brushes, I think she came out with new colors, new packaging too. But I really been liking these two palettes right here, and this one is in the shade medium 10. Looks like this, really pretty. Love this palette, I really like it. And this is in the shade Fair Light. It's this one right here, so pretty. I really like this palette, are really blendable, really like it, and I really want to try the new colors palettes that she came out with. So yeah, so that's pretty much all for my face. So now for setting spray, I've been using this one from the Too Faced Hangover RxX, and also I'll be using the In Beauty Project. So I've been using these two, and they're really hydrating. It gives you like a really glow. This one gives you like a glow into your skin. This one is more like a hydrating setting spray. But the one that I have repurchased, because this is my second bottle, is the Morphe Illuminating Setting Spray. I really use one bottle. This is my second one, and I really like it, like the finish that it give you. It gives me like a really nice glow, and I really like it, and it sets my makeup too. So I've been liking these three setting sprays. For highlighters, I've been loving this mini highlighters from Pixi. And this is Pixi by Petra, and this is the Subtle Sunrise. I really like this highlighter. I think everybody's been raving about this highlighter. It's not new from this year. I think about it last year, but I've really been using a lot of this highlighter. And also for palettes, I want to mention this palette, and this one is from a YouTuber. Her name is Jackie Hernandez, and this is the OMG. Her company is Jadis. And I've really been using this highlighter palette. As you can see, it's well loved. I've really been using a lot of this palette. These shades are really great for my skin tone. They're not too dark, so I just mix everything together. And yes, yeah, so I've really been liking this this highlighter palette. And also, Iman, she's a YouTuber as well. She collabed with Catrice, and she came out with this palette too. And this is the Catrice, and this is the highlighter palette that she came out. This palette is really beaming. It's really like intense, and I really like it. And I really like these three shades. This one is a little bit too dark, but if you mix this one with this white shade, you will tone the color a little bit down. But I really like this palette. This palette is whenever I want to like bam highlighter, that's when I grab this palette. But these palettes are really great. I really like it. And yes, so they're my favorite. So moving on with eyeshadow palette. So for eyeshadow, I think I'm gonna name again e.l.f. e.l.f. came out with this little bite-sized eyeshadow palette. They are really great. And yeah, I have five of their five shadow. This is like a $3 eyeshadow. You get four colors on each little compact, and they're really perfect. So look at these colors. I haven't done looks using this palette, and you can see like those looks that you create with this palette. You can like, it's great. Like the formula is great, the colors is great. You can find a color that you want. So yeah, so these palettes are really great, really affordable. And for another face palette that I'm be using a lot is this one from Jadis as well, from Jackie Hernandez. Yes, and this is the Ice Cream Shop palette. It's this one right here. It looks pretty cool, but look at this shade. These shades are really stunning. They're great for your everyday makeup look. And yeah, so I've really been loving this this palette right here. The three beauty sponge that I want to mention in today's video, and that I've been loving all this year, and this one right here, and this is from e.l.f. too. I think I mentioned a lot of e.l.f. product, but e.l.f. has been killing this year. They came out with really great product, really affordable. So this sponge is only $5. They're really soft. Really, I really like this sponge a lot. It has a flat side for your foundation and it has a pointy side for your concealer as well. So I really like this. This sponge is really soft. And also Wet n Wild has a sponge that is really nice as well. I really like it. So yeah, so this one right here has a flat side too, but has a flat side too and a pointy tip. So I really like this one. And also e.l.f. came out with this sponge right here, and this is a sponge, I think this is the camel sponge, and they came out when they released this concealer. So this one is meant to use for concealer, but since my face is small, I use this sponge to blend my foundation as well, and also for my concealer. So they're really great. E.l.f. is been killing it, and yeah, so I really like those three sponges. Okay, for eyeliner I've been using these two eyeliners. So the first eyeliner is the Stila Stale Day Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner, and I have in the shade black. It's this one right here. I really like felt tips eyeliner. I think it works better for me. I'm not great doing my wing liner, so this one works better for me. And also been using this one from Patrick Star, and this is the One Side Point Made Bodacious Black is the shade. So this is the eyeliner. I have a review with to this eyeliner. I really like it. It's the same shape of the other one, and I really like it. This eyeliner is really black, matte, and stunning. I really like it, and it stays put all day. So I really like these two eyeliners, and I've been using these two eyeliners all this year. For gel pencils, I really like this one from Essence. I really like some of my looks to put a new color in my waterline, because I feel it opens your eyes more. And I really been loving this one from Essence. They're really soft and it glides into your waterline really nice. And for a black liner, I've been using this from Araceli, and this is the Ojos Perfectos Gel Pencil Liner, and it's really black, really opaque, really stunning, and it stays in your waterline all day too. So I really like these two pencils, and yeah. Okay, and for lips, I've been loving this one from e.l.f. also. This is the, what is the name? This is the SRSLY Satin. So this is the name of the lipstick. So I have in the shade, the colors that I've been loving is the shade Cream and the shade Nectar. So as you can see, they're nudes. I love wearing nudes. So this is both of the colors. They're really stunning, great for every day. So I really like their formula. I don't like matte lipsticks. I like more creamy lipsticks, satin lipsticks. I think those lipsticks are really comfortable. I don't like the feeling of a dry, crusty lips. I don't like that at all. And I also been liking this one from NYX Cosmetics. NYX came out with this lipstick this year, and I really like it. And this one is in the shade Silk. Again, this is a nude color, gray for every day. So yeah, so I've really been liking this lipstick. And for lip gloss, I've been loving this lip gloss from Allomar Cosmetics. They're really pigmented, really stunning. Let me go ahead and do you a swatch. This one right here is in the shade Coqueta. They're really pigmented, they have color. And this one that I'm gonna swatch, it came out when they turned another year. It was their birthday, and this was in the shade Birthday Suit. It's more like a pinky color, and this one is more like a warm brown color. So I really like Allomar Cosmetics formula. They're really, it's kind of like thick, but it's not sticky. I really like it. It's really comfortable, and yeah. So that's pretty much everything on the Infor lashes. So this year I learned how to put lashes, guys. I wasn't wearing any lashes before. I think in my opinion my lashes are really like long, and I really like use mascara a lot. Oh, and then you mentioned mascara. Okay, for mascara I've really been liking this one from Trite Cosmetics. This one is a tubing mascara. So what does that mean is whenever you apply, it applies like a regular mascara, but when you take off your mascara, you put a little bit of water, the mascara comes out like a tubing, so it don't do a lot of mess. And that's what I like about this mascara, it comes a lot like a tubing. It's really like a weird sensation, but I really like it. But it's because it's not messy, it doesn't leave my eye looking like a raccoon. So I really like this mascara a lot. And also a good mascara that I've been loving this year, and I don't have it with me because I already run out, and it's the Princess mascara from Essence. The Princess mascara from Essence. I will leave a picture right here so y'all can see which one, because Essence has a lot of mascaras, and some of they're good, some of they're not. But the one that I'm talking about is the black tube with green designs. So yeah, so that's the mascara that I really like. It's really volumizing, it's lengthening. So yeah, so I really like those two mascara. And the lashes that I wanna mention is, this is the Kiss and this is the number 11. So these lashes, I don't like too short lashes because I feel like it's really difficult to put it on. So I like these lashes. These lashes looks kind of like you wearing lash extension. So I really like these lashes for every day. You pretty much don't feel it into your eyes. They're really nice, and yeah, so this is my favorite lashes so far. I have a few lashes that I've been receiving, but these lashes right here are great, and it's drugstore. I think this whole five pairs of lashes kind of like $10 or $12, so you cannot beat that. And I really like these lashes, and I've been using these lashes a lot. Oh yeah, I think pretty much I covered all my favorite makeup products from my whole face. So yeah, so leave me down below what your products for 2020 was the best product that you have tried or you've been using and loving this year. So yeah, so that's pretty much everything that I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I can't wait for 2021 and see what brands release for 2021. So I'm really excited, and I'm really excited for e.l.f. because if you don't know, e.l.f. came out with a new foundation that I already ordered and it's on the way. So stay tuned for that, because I'm gonna be doing a wear test on that foundation and compare it with a dupe that I think, and that I'm hearing people saying that it's a dupe for another foundation that I do have it with me. So I'm gonna be comparing those two foundations. So yeah, so that's pretty much everything that I have for you guys today. If you like this video, please give me a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, share this video if you like. Happy New Year's, stay safe and healthy, and I'll see you in 2021. Bye guys.